This is breaking news. NASA has just confirmed that Perseverance's last sample from Jezero Crater contains features that on Earth are almost always created by microbes. Keep watching, because I'll reveal the exact chemical signature scientists found and why this could be the strongest evidence yet that Mars once hosted life. On September 10, 2025, NASA's top scientist stood before the world and called this the clearest sign of life that we've ever found on Mars. The announcement wasn't just another routine update from the Red Planet. It was the result of a year-long peer-reviewed investigation, with every detail scrutinized by planetary scientists, chemists, and astrobiologists from around the globe. The sample at the heart of this excitement comes from a site called Cheyava Falls, deep within Jezero Crater, a place already famous for its ancient river delta and the tantalizing clues it's yielded about the watery past of Mars. So what exactly did Perseverance uncover that has the scientific community buzzing? The rover drilled into a mudstone boulder and extracted a core sample known as Sapphire Canyon. When the team analyzed this sample, they found something extraordinary: clusters of iron phosphate and iron sulfide minerals, specifically vivianite and greigite, arranged in distinct millimeter-sized leopard spots. These aren't just random mineral blobs. On Earth, vivianite often forms in sediments where decaying organic matter is present, while greigite is a mineral that certain microbes produce as part of their metabolism. The arrangement and context of these minerals in the Martian rock are what makes this discovery so exclusive. But the intrigue doesn't stop with the minerals themselves. The chemical environment of the Sapphire Canyon sample is just as compelling. The rock is packed with organic carbon, sulfur, and phosphorus, three elements that, when found together in this kind of setting, create a chemical fingerprint that, on our planet, is almost always left behind by living things. These elements are locked into the clay and silt of the mudstone, which formed billions of years ago at the bottom of an ancient river valley. The preservation of these compounds in such a pristine state is rare even on Earth, where geological recycling tends to erase the traces of ancient life over time. What makes this find even more remarkable is the context in which it was made. Jezero Crater is a site that scientists have long suspected was once home to a lake, fed by rivers that carried clay, silt, and organic material into its depths. The mudstones Perseverance is sampling are the remnants of this ancient lake bed, and they've been largely undisturbed for billions of years. This means that any biosignatures, chemical or mineral traces left by life, have had a much better chance of surviving than they would in more geologically active regions. NASA's announcement emphasized that this is not just another interesting rock. The combination of mineral patterns, chemical signatures, and geological contacts makes Sapphire Canyon the most promising candidate yet for evidence of ancient Martian life. The agency's scientists were careful to stress that while these features are consistent with biological processes, they are not definitive proof. There are still non-biological ways these minerals could have formed, though none fit the data as neatly as the biological explanation. That's why the discovery is being called a potential biosignature, a feature that could be consistent with life but needs more study to confirm its origin. The rarity of these mineral patterns is another reason this discovery stands out. Previous Mars missions have found hints of organic molecules and possible biosignatures, but nothing with the same combination of visual, chemical, and structural evidence. Even on Earth, leopard spot, vivianite, and greigite clusters are uncommon because tectonic activity, erosion, and weathering usually destroy such delicate features over time. Mars, with its ancient and relatively stable surface, acts as a kind of time capsule, preserving clues that would have vanished long ago on our own planet. Of course, the big question remains: could anything other than life have created these features? That's the mystery that scientists are now racing to solve. The Perseverance team is using every tool at their disposal to rule out non-biological explanations, but the final answer may have to wait until samples can be returned to Earth for more detailed analysis. For now, Sapphire Canyon stands as the strongest candidate yet in the search for life beyond Earth, a discovery that's exclusive not just because of what was found, but because of how rare and precious such evidence truly is. The uniqueness of this Martian discovery isn't just about what was found, but how it stands apart from everything that's come before. While the initial findings from Sapphire Canyon set the scientific world abuzz, what's truly remarkable is how the leopard spots and poppy seeds and the bright angel formation defy expectations. Unlike anything uncovered by previous Mars missions, these features are chemically and structurally distinct, and their preservation in such young sedimentary rocks is a rarity, even by Earth standards. This suggests that Mars may have remained a potentially habitable world for much longer than previously believed, extending the timeline for when life could have existed. What's especially striking is the arrangement of these minerals. On our planet, similar patterns are almost always erased by the relentless forces of tectonics and erosion. Mars, with its ancient and relatively undisturbed surface, acts as a time capsule, preserving these delicate clues for billions of years. The leopard spots are clusters of vivianite and greigite surrounded by altered clay, while the poppy seeds are tiny inclusions that stand out against the surrounding rock. These aren't just visually interesting. They are the result of specific chemical reactions that on Earth are usually sparked by living organisms. The fact that these patterns have survived so long on Mars gives scientists a rare opportunity to study what could be the aftermath of ancient biological activity. But the real question is, why can't scientists just declare life found and move on? The answer lies in the rigorous standards of scientific proof. While the evidence is compelling, every possible non-biological explanation must be tested and ruled out. Some researchers propose that slow chemical reactions involving Martian groundwater or unique sediment compositions could mimic the patterns seen in the bright angel rocks. Others suggest that interactions between organic molecules and minerals, even without life, might produce similar results. However, none of these scenarios fit all the data as neatly as the biological hypothesis. The absence of signs pointing to high temperatures or volcanic activity further narrows the list of plausible non-living origins. This is where the scientific process becomes both a challenge and a thrill. The Perseverance team is using advanced modeling and laboratory simulations to test every alternative. They're comparing the Martian samples to terrestrial analogs, running experiments to see if similar mineral patterns can form without biology, and scrutinizing every detail for inconsistencies. The bar for proof is set incredibly high, and for good reason. Declaring life on another planet would be one of the most profound discoveries in human history. Hey Curious Squad, before we dig even deeper into the science, make sure to hit like and subscribe if you want to stay updated on the latest breakthroughs in space exploration and the search for life beyond Earth. Your support helps us keep bringing you the most fascinating stories from the cosmos. One of the biggest hurdles is the limitation of the instruments currently on Mars. While Perseverance's tools are cutting edge for a rover, they can't match the sensitivity and precision of Earth-based laboratories. The rover can detect organic molecules, map mineral structures, and analyze chemical gradients, but it can't directly observe fossilized cells or complex biological signatures. That's why the Mars sample return mission is so crucial. If these rocks can be brought back to Earth, scientists will be able to perform tests that could definitively confirm or refute a biological origin, like analyzing isotopic ratios, searching for microfossils, and conducting high-resolution imaging. Meanwhile, the discovery has already set off a wave of new mission planning. NASA and its international partners are targeting similar sedimentary formations elsewhere on Mars, hoping to find even more compelling evidence. The European Space Agency's Rosalin Franklin rover, for example, is designed to drill deeper than any previous mission, reaching layers that have been shielded from radiation and erosion for eons. Each new mission builds on the last, expanding the search for biosignatures and pushing the boundaries of what we know about the history of Mars. As the debate continues, the scientific community is energized by the possibilities. The discovery has sparked new questions about the persistence of habitable environments, the resilience of biosignatures, and the very definition of life itself. If these patterns truly are fingerprints of ancient Martian microbes, it would mean that life is not a cosmic fluke, but a natural outcome wherever the right conditions exist. And if not, the search will continue, driven by the same curiosity and determination that led to this extraordinary moment. Every new clue brings us closer to answering one of humanity's oldest and most profound questions. The global impact of this Martian discovery is already reshaping the way scientists approach the search for life beyond Earth. NASA's announcement wasn't just a headline, it was the result of a year-long peer-reviewed process that brought together experts from around the world. This level of scrutiny and collaboration is being hailed as the gold standard for astrobiology, setting a new precedent for how extraordinary claims are tested and validated. The Sapphire Canyon sample, with its unique mineral patterns and chemical signatures, has become a focal point for international research teams eager to test their own models and hypotheses against the data. What makes this process so exclusive is the sheer depth of expertise involved. Chemists, geologists, biologists, and planetary scientists have all weighed in, challenging each other's interpretations and pushing the boundaries of what's possible with remote analysis. The result is a discovery that stands on the firmest scientific ground available, given the limitations of working with robotic instruments millions of miles away. This collaborative approach is inspiring new partnerships and mission proposals, as agencies around the globe recognize the value of pooling resources and knowledge in the quest to answer one of humanity's oldest questions. If the patterns and chemical fingerprints in the Sapphire Canyon sample are indeed the result of ancient Martian microbes, the implications are staggering. Developing the idea that life is not a rare cosmic accident, but a likely outcome wherever the right ingredients exist, would fundamentally reshape our understanding of biology, evolution, and the potential for life elsewhere in the universe. The discovery is already influencing the design of future missions, not just to Mars, but to other worlds where similar processes might be at work. Places like Europa, Enceladus, or even the subsurface oceans of distant exoplanets. Yet for all the excitement, there are still major hurdles to overcome. The Mars sample return mission, which would bring these precious rocks back to Earth for definitive analysis, faces significant technical and financial challenges. If the mission is delayed or canceled, the answer to whether Mars once hosted life could remain tantalizingly out of reach. Scientists are already exploring alternative strategies, such as developing more advanced instruments that could be sent to Mars or forming new international partnerships to share the cost and expertise required for such an ambitious project. Meanwhile, the discovery has sparked a renewed sense of urgency and creativity in the planetary science community. Researchers are proposing new missions to target older and deeper layers of Martian rock, where biosignatures might be even better preserved. The European Space Agency's Rosalind Franklin rover, for example, carrying a more advanced drilling power, as we mentioned earlier. These efforts are driven by the hope that most compelling evidence for life on Mars may still be waiting, locked away beneath the surface. The broader impact of this discovery extends beyond science. NASA's commitment to transparency, sharing raw data, peer-reviewed findings, and even the uncertainties has inspired public interest and trust. The story of perseverance in the Sapphire Canyon sample is capturing imaginations around the world, encouraging a new generation to pursue careers in science, engineering, and exploration. It's a reminder that the search for life is not just a scientific quest, but a deeply human one, driven by curiosity and the desire to understand our place in the cosmos. As we look to the future, the questions only grow more intriguing. What if the Mars sample return mission never gets off the ground? Will we ever know for sure if life once existed on Mars? Could there be even more dramatic evidence waiting in older or deeper Martian rocks, just beyond the reach of our current technology? And if we do find definitive proof, how will it change the way we see ourselves and our place in the universe? So what do you think? Are we on the verge of the most important discovery in human history? Or is Mars still keeping its secrets hidden for a little while longer? Share your thoughts in the comments below. Now, check out this video on our end screens to learn more about the three mysterious interstellar objects we found.